Hello. Today we'll look at 10 tasks a SAS Viya administrator should carry out to keep their SAS Viya deployment running smoothly. I'm David Stern, and this is the Technical Insights and Expertise series. As I count down my top 10, you may wonder why these particular tasks, or why didn't I include something that's particularly important to you? I've simply chosen 10 tasks that I think will be relevant to the largest number of SAS Viya deployments. You can read more about these tasks and many others in my checklist of SAS Viya administration tasks. It's available at the URL on screen and in the video's description, and I'll show this URL again at the end of the video. Of course, every SAS Viya deployment has its own particular combination of products and its own unique end-user created content, so the list of which administration tasks are most important will obviously vary between SAS Viya deployments. This video is intended to make some suggestions about what you might need to do and to show you where to find out more. If you're already doing all of the things in this top 10, that's excellent. Perhaps you'll find something else that is useful in the checklist paper. I've organized the paper into two lists of tasks. First, it lists initial tasks you would perform after you first get your SAS Viya deployment or after a major change or upgrade. Then there is a second list of tasks to consider performing regularly. With that, let's count down my top 10 SAS Viya administration tasks. 10. Mirror repositories and updates. You can deploy SAS Viya using a SAS-hosted repository, but we update our repository frequently, and it's better to create and keep a mirror repository for each version of SAS Viya you currently have deployed. By doing that, you can repair or expand your deployment with the same version of the SAS Viya software that your other hosts are running. Task number 31 in the checklist paper has more detail. Know how to keep up to date with SAS updates, as described in task number 25. The URLs on screen are good places to find out what updates are available for your version of SAS Viya, and you can subscribe to be notified when new updates are released. Think about when and how you will apply updates while keeping your service level agreements with your users. When you know how to do that, periodically check for updates. 9. Licenses and certificates. Task number 35 describes where you can learn about how to apply updated licenses to SAS and third-party products and components used in the SAS platform. You should note how to perform this procedure on your site, as it's usually something you only do once a year, and it can be easy to forget how to do it. Also, remember to allow enough time to get your new license before the existing one runs out. Ensure you know how to create new TLS certificates for your SAS platform. Task 36 in the paper discusses that. 8. Monitoring. For enterprise-scale deployments, task 2 is to define a service level agreement, an SLA, which states the measures you will use for service level monitoring and reporting, and how they will be calculated. Task 12. Know how to check the status of all your SAS Viya services ad hoc at any time. Tasks 14 and 15 suggest setting up automated monitoring to regularly check the status of your SAS Viya services, as well as key metrics for the hosts on which they run, like disk space, memory, and network use. Also, consider implementing an alerting tool. Remember that you'll rarely be in front of your computer watching how the system is performing when something unusual happens. So, while it's great to be able to see what's happening now, it's much more useful to be able to see what happened in the last few hours and days, and to be able to set up alerts so that you're notified when, for example, a job fails, a process stops running, a disk fills, or a particular message appears in a log file. You should also monitor the performance of jobs and queries running on the system. This includes interactive jobs and user workload, as well as scheduled jobs and workflows. It's a good idea to identify the longest running jobs, data steps, or queries, and focus your efforts on those to see if they can be made more efficient. Many further tasks in the checklist's regular task list cover monitoring both your hosts and your SAS Viya jobs and services. 7. SAS Work Directory. The default location for SAS Work libraries on Unix and Linux deployments is the temp directory, and on Windows it's the user's home directory. These locations are sure to exist, and the user will have write access to them, but they're not the ideal place to store temporary data. Task 34 in the checklist explains where to learn how to change the SAS Work directory path to a better location, ideally faster, dedicated storage optimized for large sequential reads and writes. The Clean Work utility may be familiar to administrators of SAS 9 deployments, and it's also included with SAS Viya. Abandoned SAS Work directories left behind by abruptly terminated SAS sessions seem to be much less of an issue in SAS Viya than they sometimes were in earlier versions of SAS, but it's worth familiarising yourself with this utility just in case. Tasks 26 and 51 cover how and when to use it. 6. Users and security model. Larger organisations should have a security policy that covers all of their IT systems, including SAS. A SAS administrator should design an authorization model that follows this security policy in describing how users are onboarded and offboarded, where groups are defined, and how their access to content, data, and application functionality is managed. Tasks 5, 6, and 7 in the checklist cover those topics. You should also have a process that ensures you know when users are added or removed from your SAS Viya deployment, so that you can follow your onboarding and offboarding procedures for those users. Task 39 discusses that. Designing and implementing an authorization model is a significant part of a SAS administrator's job. When designing an authorization model, it's really helpful to begin by thinking about what resources you need to protect, for example, folders in a SAS Viya folder structure, and what level of access to each resource you intend to grant to each group. I like to do this in a sort of plain English way first, thinking about read and read-write or administrator access. This allows you to agree the general idea in discussion with business stakeholders without having to get into technical detail that would be confusing to that audience. Once that's done, you can make more detailed decisions about what technical permissions or access controls you need to grant comparatively easily. 5. Move content between deployments. SAS Viya administrators who are upgrading from SAS 9 need to know what content can be moved from SAS 9 into SAS Viya and how to move it. Administrators with more than one SAS Viya deployment or who are migrating to a new deployment need to know what content can be promoted between SAS Viya deployments and how. See Task 27 for more on this. Think carefully before promoting permissions, authorization rules, or access controls with your content and data. It may be simpler and more straightforward to not promote those things and design an authorization model in your target environment separately. 4. Backup. Your service level agreement should include objectives for being able to recover your deployment to an earlier point in time in case someone makes a maintenance or system configuration error which is difficult to recover from. Define a backup and restore strategy. Your strategy should describe which components of the SAS platform should be backed up, how frequently, and for how long the backups should be retained in what locations. This seemingly simple task can actually be extremely complex for a distributed multi-machine SAS Viya deployment. This is because configuration and state for a SAS Viya deployment is kept in several different places. You need to back up those places synchronously, in other words at the same time, in order to properly capture the current state of your whole SAS Viya deployment. Restoring different parts of the deployment using backups taken at different times would leave the deployment in an inconsistent state. Good, frequent backups are also essential to disaster recovery, though of course they do not provide disaster recovery capability on their own. Tasks 2 and 19 address some of those topics. The checklist also has regular tasks 48 and 49 to execute backups and periodically test the restore process. After all, backups are only reliable if you know you can successfully restore from them. 3. Logs. Logs are the best way to see the detail of what is happening in your SAS Viya deployment. A large proportion of calls to SAS technical support will involve you sending log files, perhaps after temporarily changing a logging level. Remember to turn the logging level back to its original value when you're finished, or the logs may quickly get very large. Task 22 points you to guidance on how to change logging levels and how to find the messages in SAS log files that will help you to understand what is happening. Regular Task 53 is to monitor the logs page in SAS Environment Manager to help you spot issues that require your attention before someone else tells you there's a problem. 2. Start and stop SAS Viya services. If you have a multi-machine SAS Viya deployment, Task 13 of the checklist is essential. It shows you where to find the Multi-Machine Services Utilities playbooks in the SAS Viya Administration Resource Kit, or SAS Viya ARC, on GitHub. These Ansible playbooks are fully working examples which coordinate the startup and shutdown of your SAS Viya services in the right sequence across multiple hosts. So why is that important? When all the SAS Viya components are deployed on a single host in a non-distributed way, then the SAS Viya All Services script can take care of starting and stopping those services perfectly well. It's provided with your SAS Viya software and is registered as a service. However, it's very common to have SAS Viya deployed across many hosts in a distributed way, a multi-machine deployment. In a deployment like this, there's still a SAS Viya All Services script on each host registered as a service. But when you run the script on one host, it has no way to start services on another host. Plus, if your whole environment restarts, you may not be able to control in which order or how quickly the hosts themselves start up. The result is that it's practically impossible for the SAS Viya All Services script to bring up your SAS Viya services in the correct order. Some services inevitably start up before another service on which they depend, and then either fail or enter an error state. To work correctly, your SAS Viya services must start up in the following sequence, orchestrated across the whole deployment. The primary SAS configuration server, that is, console, must start first. Many of the other services depend on this service for configuration information, and they all need to register themselves in the SAS configuration server in order to be found by other services. After that, the non-primary SAS configuration services running on the other hosts in your deployment need to start. This includes the secondary SAS configuration server if you have one, and all the agents. The next services to come up should be the SAS Secret Manager, used to store secrets, keys, and certificates, and then the SAS Message Broker. Next, the SAS Infrastructure Data Server can start, followed by the HTTP Proxy Service, which in turn must be up before you start the primary CAS controller. The primary CAS controller then automatically starts the secondary CAS controller, if there is one, and all the CAS worker processes. After that, all the other SAS microservices can start up. I won't show the shutdown sequence, but it's more or less the reverse of the startup sequence. It is equally important to shut down your services in the required order across the whole deployment so that they deregister themselves correctly in the SAS configuration server, leaving it in a tidy state for the next time you start up your services. If you don't do that, you may have trouble starting your services next time and have to perform some cleanup first. If you don't already have it, find the SAS Viya Administration Resource Kit on GitHub to learn more about this brilliant set of tools. Specifically, the ViaArc Multi-Machine Service Utility Playbooks are written to be run from your Ansible Controller's SAS Viya Playbook directory. They use your existing inventory.ini file to locate the SAS Viya services on each machine in your deployment. You can get a copy of the playbooks on your Ansible controller by running a sequence of bash commands something like this. These commands use Git to clone the SAS ViaArc project and make a copy of the project below your SAS Viya playbook directory. Obviously, adapt these commands to your environment as necessary, and we've included them in the description for this video. You can then use the Ansible playbook command to run a multi-machine service utility playbook to check the status of all your SAS Viya services, or to stop, start, or restart them all in the correct sequence across all of your hosts. And that brings us to the last task in our countdown. 1. Regular task schedule. Design and maintain a schedule of SAS platform administration housekeeping activities to specify when regular tasks should be performed. You'll need to decide which tasks in the checklist are important to you and which to perform daily, monthly, annually, or at some other frequency. Obviously, include other tasks in your schedule that make sense for your particular situation. Then follow that schedule and perform each of your set of maintenance tasks to help keep your SAS Viya deployment healthy, secure, and running effectively so that it meets all your business and end user stakeholders' needs. You'll probably want to consider writing scripts to help you with some tasks. Learn how to use the brilliant SAS administration command line interface, known as the SAS Admin CLI. There are good scripting ideas and examples on the developer.sas.com site, and we've shared some Python tools that were useful to us in our PyViya Tools project on GitHub. So that's it for my top 10. Let me know if you find it useful or if there are things that would be in your top 10 that I didn't mention. There's a list of all the URLs referenced in these slides in the description for this video. You might have to click Show More to see them. And please check out some of the other videos in the SAS Technical Insights and Expertise series. Thanks for watching.